Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be showing you how to create this really simple look using some new products that I absolutely love. So before we kick off, I'll just let you know that I have just laminated my eyebrows myself using the lamination products from Beautiful Brows and Lashes, and I'm actually so happy with how they turned out, seeing as I'm not a professional. So just to emphasise my newly laminated brows, I'm going in with the conditioning primer from Benefit just to make them all stand up really nice and straight and go the way that I want them to go. And to give them that extra little bit of fullness, I'm going to take my Sigma Cosmetics brow pomade and an angled brush from Glossy Box, and I'm just going to fill my brows in, creating natural like brush strokes and giving them that extra bit of definition. I always find the best way to do this is to just take your time when filling out your eyebrows so that you get them nice and precise and you don't have to rush, just get them exactly how you want them. And once they're filled out how you like them, I like to take the highbrow highlighting pencil from Benefit and just underline what you've created. Now that my eyebrow bone is nicely highlighted, I'm just taking the Illamasqua Skin Base Concealer Pen and I'm placing that all over my eyelids to prepare for eyeshadow. I've really fallen in love with this Illamasqua concealer. It's got a great consistency and it gives excellent coverage. And obviously, once you've completed your first brow, go ahead and repeat on the second brow. So, to create this simple eye look, I've gone back to the Origin palette from Beauty Bay, which I absolutely love, and I'm taking the first transition shade of the first column, which is a really nice orangey, kind of burnt peachy kind of shade, which I really, really like, and especially for this time of year, I think it's a great spring look. So as I said, I'm taking that shade, using my MAC 214 brush, and just placing that all over the lid. And then we're going to blend that out with my Zoeva Luxe Crease 228 Blending Brush, which is my all-time favourite crease blender. So to make this look pop, I'm going to add a really nice wing. So today I'm using the Precision Gel Liner from Illamasqua and I'm going in with their 015 liner brush, which is a really nice fine brush. Now I tend to go for a pen type liquid eyeliner, but this has completely changed my opinion. I absolutely love how precise it is and I love how easily it glides on because of the really nice creamy but matte texture. So I find applying a winged eyeliner in two stages is the easiest way to do this. So I like to start by creating the top line and then creating the little line to form the wing and then filling that out. Now to quickly and easily take this look to the next level, I'm using the Stila Glitter and Glow Liquid Eyeshadow in gold and I'm just packing a small amount of that into the inner corner of the eye and that completes the eye look. So now I'm going in with the Benefit Poreless Primer. Now this primer is my all-time favourite and I think until someone can create a better one, I'm not going to be using anything else. It just really makes makeup sit nicely and evenly on my skin. And now to get an even coverage but still enhancing a nice glowy complexion, I'm going to be cocktailing together two foundations, the Illamasqua Skin Base and the It Cosmetics CC Plus Illumination Full Coverage Cream. Now, I find that if you're trying to achieve a glowy and dewy yet full coverage look, this combination really, really works for me. It doesn't dry out my skin too much and it really enhances your skin's natural texture. And I'm just buffing this in the Buff Beauty Bay foundation brush, which I just find gives fantastic coverage and really sort of packs the colour into your skin. So now the foundation's all evenly blended out, I'm going to be taking the Illamasqua concealer again and just highlighting certain areas of my face. So I like to do under my eyes, my nose, my top lip and my chin, but these highlighting areas are really different for everybody. So, you know, you might want to add a little bit to your temple or your collarbones or something like that to just get a little bit more highlight in there, and then buff it out again with the same brush. And after it's all buffed out, I like to refine that with a beauty blender just to make sure it really packs in under your eyes, into the little creases and everything, just to get fantastic coverage under there. Now, once that step's completed, I'm going to be taking my Laura Mercier translucent loose powder, which has a glow element. I always got about this in all my videos because I think it's just a fantastic product, because it really sort of brings together both powdering your face and highlighting certain areas, which really speeds things up before you contour. So I'm going in here, we're using a Benefit brush. Now, this brush is actually a blusher brush, but I find that its domed top really hugs into your cheekbones and you get a really excellent contour. And I do favour a powder contour, so I'm using my Kat Von D Shade and Light, and I'm using the darkest shade here. I just find that a powder contour blends out better for my skin, but some people find that cream contour blends out better for their skin, but I just find this really works for me. So if I'm honest with you, I never really use a blusher, but this Colour Veil liquid blusher from Illamasqua is fantastic. The shade Entice isn't too pink, it isn't too garish, and it blends into your skin using your fingers really, really well. If you just smile, produce the apples of your cheeks and apply it onto there, it gives your face just a really nice rosy glow, but nothing too much, which I really love. So now that we've applied our face makeup, I'm just going to take the Illamasqua 105 flat brush, and I'm going to take the same transition shade that we used earlier and apply that under the eye. And we're going to smudge that up right into the wing. Now, let's be honest, I wouldn't use any other mascara at the minute than the Bad Gal Bang mascara from Benefit, because I just think it's amazing. And I'm just going to apply that all over my lashes before applying some really nice fluffy false lashes. Now, the reason that I love this mascara so much is because it both separates your lashes and enhances them at the same time, adding volume and separation, which I just think is fantastic. And I'm just going to add some Eyelure lashes just to add a nice bit of glam to this look. Now my lashes are nicely secured, I'm going to go in and do my lips. So I like to apply a bit of the Fasali Rose Gold Oil to my lips just to make sure they're fully hydrated. And then I'm going in with the Taupe MAC lip liner here, which I will be following with the Illamasqua Anti-Matter Lipstick in shade Gravity, which is a really nice rich brown shade. Adding a bold dark lip like this really gives the look that amazing finish you want. So there we have it. I hope you enjoyed my video today. Please give me a like, drop me a comment, please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you all soon.